Hello friends, and welcome to the tutorial on statistics using Python. At the end of the tutorial, you will be able to do statistical operations in Python, sum a set of numbers, find their mean, median and standard deviation. Before beginning this tutorial, we would suggest you to complete the tutorial on loading data from files, getting started with lists and accessing pages of arrays. So now type in terminal IPython space hyphen pylab. For this tutorial, we will use data file that is at the path /home/fossee/sslc2.txt. It contains record of students and their performance in one of the state secondary board examination. It has 180,000 lines of record. We are going to read it and then process this data. We can see the content of the file by double clicking on it. It might take some time to open since it has a quite large file. Please don't edit the data since it has a particular structure. To check the contents of the file, we use the cat command. So type cat space /home/fossee/sslc2.txt and hit enter. Each line in the file is a set of 11 fields separated by semicolons. Consider a sample line from this file. A semicolon 015163 semicolon Joseph Raj S semicolon 083 semicolon 042 semicolon 47 semicolon 00 semicolon 72 semicolon 244 then three semicolons in a row. The following are the fields in any given line: region code, which is A, roll number 015163, name Joseph Rajesh, marks of 5 subjects English 83, Hindi 42, Maths 47, Science 35, Social Science 72, and total mark is 244. Let's load this data as an array and then run various functions on it. To get the data as an array, we use the loadTxt command. So type in terminal L is equal to loadTxt within closing brackets and single quotes /home/fossee/sslc2.txt, comma, use calls, that's USCCOLS is equal to within closing brackets 34567 with commas, comma, delimiter is equal to within single quotes exclamation, semicolon. And hit enter. We got our output. Output in the form of an array dot loadTxt function. So now we got an error. So we have to type loadTxt before the brackets. So delimiter specifies the kind of character that the field of data separated by use calls specifies the columns to be used. So within brackets 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and comma loads those columns. The comma is added because use calls is a sequence. As we can see, L is an array. We can get the shape of this array using, in the terminal you can type L dot shape and hit enter. We get tuple stating that numbers of rows and columns respectively. Let's start applying statistical operations on these. We will start with the most basic, summing. How do you find the sum of marks of all subjects for the first student? As we know from our knowledge of accessing pieces of arrays, to access the first row, we will do in terminal type L square brackets 0 comma colon. Now to sum this, we can say total marks is equal to sum in closing brackets L, then in square brackets 0 comma colon, and hit enter. Then total marks, then again enter. Now to get the mean, we can divide the total marks by length. So type total marks slash LEN within brackets L in square brackets 0 comma colon. Or simply use the function mean. For that, type mean within brackets L and in square brackets 0 comma colon and hit enter. But we have such a large data sheet and calculating the mean of each student one by one is impossible. Is there a way to reduce the work? For this, we will look into the documentation of mean. So for that, type mean question mark in the terminal. As we know, L is a two-dimensional array. We can calculate the mean across each of these axes of the array. The axis of rows is referred by number 0 and columns by 1. So to calculate mean across all columns, we will pass extra parameter 1 for the axis. So type mean within brackets L comma 1 and hit enter. L here is a two-dimensional array. Similarly, to calculate average marks scored by all the students for each subject can be calculated using mean within brackets L comma 0. Next, let us calculate the median of English marks for all the students. We can access English marks of all students using L in square brackets colon comma 0 and hit enter. To get the median, we will simply use the function median. So type median in brackets L and square brackets colon comma 0. For all the subjects, we can use the same syntax as mean and calculate median across all rows using median. So type median in brackets L comma 0 and hit enter. Similarly, to calculate standard deviation for English, we will use the function std. So type std in brackets L and in square brackets colon comma 0 and hit enter. And for all rows, we do std within brackets L comma 0 and click enter. Pause the video here and try out the following exercise and resume the video. In the given file football.txt at path slash home slash fossee slash football.txt, one column is player name, second is goals at home, and third goals away. Find the total goals for each player. The second question, mean of home and away goals, and the third one, standard deviation of home and away goals. Now this is the required data. For that, open the football.txt file. The solution is on your screen. This brings us to the end of this tutorial. In this tutorial, we have learned to do the standard statistical operations sum, median, mean, and standard deviation in Python. The second one, combine text loading and the statistical operation to resolve real world problems. Here are some self-assessment questions for you. The first one, given a two-dimensional list, two hyphen dimensional hyphen list is equal to, in square brackets, 35821, comma, in another square brackets, 43621. So, how do we calculate the mean of each row? The second one, calculate the median of the given list. Students underscore marks is equal to, in square brackets, 74, 78, 56, 87, 91, 82. And the third question is, suppose there is a file with 6 columns, but we wish to load text only in the columns 2, 3, 4 and 5. So how do we specify that? Now, the answers is, the first one, to get the mean of each row, we just pass 1 as the second parameter to the function mean. So you have to type mean in brackets 2 underscore dimensional underscore list comma 1 to get the output. And for the second question, we use the function median to calculate the median of list by typing median within brackets student underscore marks. And the final one, to specify the particular columns of a file, we use the parameter use calls is equal to within brackets 2, 3, 4, 5 to get the output. So we hope you have enjoyed this tutorial and found it useful. Thank you.